There has been growing speculation over the past few weeks that North Korea is considering a third nuclear test. If Pyongyang does go ahead with the test, how will the rest of us be able to tell? Our Kim Hanul explains.
On May 25, 2009, the Korea Institute of Geoscience and Mineral Resources, a South Korean public research institution, detected a tremor from an earthquake in North Korea, measuring 5.4 on the Richter scale. As it turned out, it was an artificial earthquake caused by North Korea's second nuclear test in Pungye-ri. But scientists weren't surprised that the test was detected in this way. In 2006, a collaborative effort between seismological observatories from South Korea, China and Russia helped detect Pyongyang's first nuclear test. Now, the Korea Institute of Geoscience and Mineral Resources is currently operating in emergency mode on the heels of reports that a third nuclear test by North Korea is imminent.
When unusual movements are detected from the north, we are the first ones to detect and we pass the information onto the relevant organizations.
The underground explosion caused by a nuclear test can be detected through seismic arrays, sonic rays, and even through tiny amounts of nuclear material caught in the air. But nuclear experts say the fastest and the most accurate way to tell whether a nuclear test has been conducted is by measuring seismic activity. And South Korea has a web of domestic and international observatories that can come up with the most accurate analysis of this kind of activity.
We have 7 seismic and sonic ray observatories near the 38th parallel, and we also analyze data collected from China and Russia. So we are able to conclude that an underground explosion in North Korea was from a nuclear test.
A nuclear test can be detected by a seismic array just minutes after it is finished, while detection through sonic rays can take up to an hour. Kim Hanul, Arirang News.